First of all, I would like to thank the organizing committee for giving me the opportunity to share some thoughts about this update in the use of kite extension in CTO intervention. I have nothing to disclose. So we all know that there are many types of kite extension catheter in the market, and I do believe that most of all have a lot of experience with this kiting catheter. We have kite liner V3, tap liner, kite chiller, and guidon. To be honest, I love this express man because with the same size, we have bigger lumen. And also, the distal cylinder length is much longer as compared to the other competitors, and it has 4 side holes. This is more in detail about the features of ExpressMan. You'll see here that the tip is unbraided, and this is relatively atraumatic. It has 4 side holes, and it provides adequate blood flow, and then minimizes ischemia, of course. It is hydrophilic coated, and it reduces the resistance while advancing in tortuous anatomy. And pushability is excellent. It provides also king. It is also king resistance, and the tapered collar entry port is very good for smooth transition in delivering our gears. And this is an example of the use of ExpressMan in one of our cases. You see here that that the patient has a significant narrowing here in the proximal or osseal LAD, and this is a diagonal branch, which is a long one. We don't want to induce ischemia in this area. This is a CTO, and we introduce after balloon dilatation, we introduce this ExpressMan, and this is a retrograde. This is undergrade approach, and you'll see here the equipoise of the left and right hemodynamics, and this is thanks to the 4 side holes. So in summary, the use of kite extension catheter in CTO PCA can be classified as follows. 1 is to facilitate vessel engagement and equipment delivery, especially in patients with anomalous coronary arteries, to provide undergrade support. That is support your undergrade gear delivery, like, for example, microcatheter or balloon, to provide support in cases with uncrossable CTO, thereby we can use rotor and orbital atherectomy, and tunnel and landslide technique, as mentioned by the first speaker, and then facilitate ADR and stingray delivery. And for retrograde approach, we use this a lot, guide extension assisted reverse card technique, CTO in bifurcation, especially in osteal LAD, but also in underside branch, and the great gridding technique, and ipsilateral externalization with single guiding catheter, the so-called modified rendezvous technique. I will deal with this one by one. This is an example of the use of kite extension for CTO in anomalous coronary artery. You'll see here that this guiding catheter cannot be engaged to the ostium of the right coronary artery, which is aberrant in location, aberrant origin. So we have to use this ExpressMan kite extension catheter. Of course, we cannot advance this further down, but this allows us to advance our microcatheter and kite wire, and then we can open up the CTO. And after this, we advance our balloon, and then while inflating the balloon, we advance this ExpressMan deeper in, and then we can finish the case beautifully with implantation of 2 DES, overlapping DES. So this is first indications. The second indications for undergrade approaches for support of our microcatheter or balloon in case of uncrossable CTO. One example, calcified right coronary example, failed attempt in another hospital, and JCTO score was 4, progress CTO score 1. So even with microcatheter carafal support, various types of wires could not cross. Of course, because you have, you see here that there is a small side branch, another option would be to use a dual lumen catheter with wire anchoring. This is but in this particular case, I tried to use ExpressMan, and this is how we position guiding catheter, guide extension catheter, close to the CTO body. Then finally, with this enhanced support, Gladius X14 could cross. This is a good wire that I love very much for undercrate approach, especially if you are dealing with long CTO. However, carafal and balloon, low-profile balloon could not cross. At that time, I changed this with ExpressMan, hoping that I will change the support. I use a rota because I already have wire downstream. But then rota stuck in the guide liner, very deep fractured, and I changed to orbital atherectomy, and this is the wire fragment is over there, and we use orbital atherectomy. And we advance this outside the body and then introduce this as a single unit. So we tried to retrieve this wire with a triple wire technique, twisting wire technique, but still failed to retain this fractured wire. So we leave this in situ, and we finish the case sandwiching this fractured wire, but ultimate result was excellent. This is what has mentioned by my dear colleague. Of course, I don't want to elaborate this further. As I mentioned, using two guiding catheter is another option. This is another example. In post-CABET patients, if we have SVG lesions, of course, if the lesion is simple, discrete, without diffuse degeneration, no visible thrombus, no mobile thrombi, not orto-ostial, not distal, distal anastomosis, SVG is not too old, able to use as ABD, and the native vessel supplying the same territory is a complex or high risk, we can treat the SVG lesion. But otherwise, it is always better to treat the native coronary artery lesion when it is simple, and the SVG lesion is, on the other hand, complex. So, this is a case example where we use a guide extension, reverse card technique for a stumpless CTO at bifurcation and degenerated vein graft. You see here, there is a critical narrowing. I think you will agree with me. This will create a problem if you approach this. And of course, you may have to use an embolic protection device. May not be very successful. But then patient has here CTO and no stump, stumpless CTO at the bifurcation of the obtuse marginal LPL. So this is ipsilateral. Double guiding catheter, retrograde approach, reverse card using Corsair. Corsair was introduced to the CIRC, and then guide liner assisted approach, and the guide wire was changed. After we advanced this with after trapping with Corsair, and then advanced this into the guide extension catheter. So you'll see here. This is an undergrade DES placement. A wire is already externalized. And then final result is very much acceptable. Of course, we may opt to coil this side branch stenosis. So this is another case, another indication for use of guide extension at bifurcation site. This is an example where the bifurcation is the in the osteal of the LED. You see stumbleless osteal LED CTO. You see here, this may help us in directing our wire, the guide extension. Fortunately, a patient has a good septal collateral, serenthrop 3, Wenner CC3, J channel score was 0. And you see here that the guide liner was placed in the left main here, exactly at the proximal cap. And then after crossing the septal channel with the Shuo guide wire and Caravelle, this radial guide wire was navigated to enter the guide liner, trapping technique, and subsequent procedure was very standard, standing procedure and excellent result. And this is the so-called active greeting technique, another technique. Sometimes with retrograde technique, we encounter difficulty in advancing our retrograde wire to enter the guiding catheter. So this is a patient who has blunt stump, calcification, the CTO segment, JCTO score 2, progress CTO score 1, and the great parallel wire wiring failed, but there is no promising collaterals from the CIRC. Fortunately, there is a very good septal collateral, Renthrop 3, Wenner CC3, J channel, score, collateral score was 0. But patient has a significant narrowing here. So we don't want to induce donor ischemia. So we fix this first with a double stenting procedure using DK crush technique and get good result enough that will be easily can navigate our guide wire to the proximal RCA, as shown here. Very, very easy assisted with the Caravelle. But then we encounter difficulty to advance our wire to the guiding catheter. The rotational angio confirmed parallel movement of both guide wires, even with coaxial guiding alignment, deep seating, and so on. So then we proceeded with the CTO segment here, dilatations with appropriately sized balloon. This is very important, appropriately sized balloon. And then using a dilated balloon as anchor, we advance our guide extension catheter over the balloon catheter here as deep as possible. We don't have to fear inducing perforation as long as we know that our gears are in the vessel architecture. So, of course, we have to beware of ischemia. And this is, after that, procedure is very standard. We can easily advance our retrograde wire into the guide extension catheter to enter the guide catheter. Trapping technique, and then advance microcatheter, exchange the wire, externalizations, and then stenting procedure, undergrade stenting, three overlapping DS with very good result. This is a guide extension catheter for ipsilateral externalization. The technique was invented by Konstantinidis and George Shianos, already published in your intervention. And this is a patient with mid LED CTO, JCTO score was 2, but there is no interventional collaterals. But the selective transjection through fine cross catheter delineated the course of a CC2 septal collateral. So the idea is that you introduce a guide extension catheter if you cannot advance your retrograde gears. So advance this guide extension catheter, then introduce the retrograde wire like this. You see this is a tip of retrograde wire into the guide extension catheter, and then do the trapping technique with the balloon introduced inside the guide extension catheter. So we can just use one single catheter and one extra microcatheter, but inside the guiding catheter. This is single catheter technique for ipsilateral approach for CTO. So this is the trapping balloon inside the guide extension catheter. Pancreas can be advanced, and then the procedure, the remaining of the procedure is very standard.
What size of guiding catheter do you need for this technique with only one single
usually
guiding
catheter? Usually 7 French is better.
7 French.
So and for all CTO, I almost never use 6 French.
Okay. So you always
use
7 French.
I never use 8 French.
And the guiding extension catheter is 5 French or 6?
Yeah, 5 or 6 French.
Then
five
you have the space.
French. 5 or 6 French.
Yeah. Okay.
With Expressman, for 6 men catheter, we can use 6 French. Expressman. You can get a better lumen. But anyway, in short, these are some examples of the indications or the utility of guide extension in CTO for undergrade and retrograde approach. And you see, you'll agree with me that the result is very gratifying. So this is a guide extension is an indispensable armamentarium in our CTO toolbox. Merci beaucoup.
Congratulations, Dr. Santoso. It's a great, amazing presentation. At the beginning, when we start with the CTO, we learned how the development of devices, the development of techniques has increased in all around the world. At the beginning, the guiding extensions as a tool, we think that it was only for support, only for deliver the stent. But we learned in just 3 presentations in this meeting that we are plenty of new uses for the guiding extension, for the microcatheters, for the guide wires, plenty of new techniques that maybe we never heard about it. And we see how the development of this specific tool, the guide extension, has increased. Now with tapered guiding extension, with longer cylinders, with side holes that improve the ischemia segment, and sometimes we use it in some manners that we never used it before. Like an example, when you present this case of the venous vein graft, we can use this longer cylinder of the Expressman, going more deeper in the venous vein graft with less ischemia because of the side holes, and you can finish the procedure with a better side branch perfusions to the distal cap. Now, I would like to ask you about how is your algorithm to choose, which algorithm do you use to choose which guide extensions first? Or how is your manner of or choose your guide extension? Why Expressman in this case? Why Trapliner in another case? How do you choose the guide extension?
I must say this is a compilation of cases from my past experience. So I don't want to be biased, but nowadays, as I said before, I use
here,
mainly I use mainly Expressman for reasons that I've elaborated because of all the good features of Expressman.
Okay. Another question, please.
Thanks for your excellent and concise review for the guide extension. One question for the first two slides. You mentioned the Expressman guide extension had one kind of very special design is tapered. Can you put more in detail tapered the guide extension?
Tapered guide extension.
Yes.
To be honest, I'm not aware of the availability of tapered guide extension, number one. And number two, I don't think that it is very use. There is a specific use of tapered end of the guide extension, because normally, if we want to advance our guide extension, we already have gears outside the lumen, like balloon or any other devices or catheter. So this will protect trauma to the vessel wall. But on top of that, this guide extension catheter expressman is relatively atraumatic, very flexible, very deliverable, and kicking resistant. So I feel very comfortable in using it. Not because I am supported by the sponsor. No, not at all. But this is an honest statement. So I don't think that the tapered end of the guide extension is important. But more important is the distal end, because it in this type of catheter, it allows us to very easily introduce our other gears to enter the guide liner, the cylinder, the 35 millimeter cylinder.
The question is, do we need a side-holded guide extension for every complex intervention?
Because I think so. I usually
preserve the amount of contrast medium. So with the four side hole, will in not so complex intervention, will increase the amount of contrast?
No, I don't think so.
Thank you very much.
Another property of the use of this type of extension.
Another good thing is that if we want to use CTO, OCT, sometimes we use also CTO. Is OCT, not IFOS. Most of the cases, IFOS. But sometimes, if there is a distal flow, we use OCT also, because with OCT, we can better characterize the plaque composition and so on. But if you have side holes, you have distal four side holes, image quality would be perfect. Perfect.
The use of the side holes guide extensions is inside the vessel, not in the aorta. That's why the contrast, the amount of contrast, doesn't change with the use of side hole, because the contrast remains inside the vessel. You don't lose the contrast with in the aorta. And that's why you don't increase the amount of contrast when you use the side holes inside of this.
And we recommend also, when you have to inject inside an extension of guiding catheter, to decrease the amount of the contrast. If you have automatic contrast injector or not, then you have to decrease it. So no problem for the amount of contrast.
Thank you. Another question?
I think we have to
move to the next slide. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Congratulations.
Thank you.